Hello everyone, my name is Clément Gignac. I'm a Senior VP and Chief Economist for IA Financial Group. Over the next 5 to 7 minutes, I would like to summarize the webinar that we have just recorded for our clients and the financial advisor. We will talk about the outlook for 2019. But before sharing with you my view on 2019, why not take a few seconds or 1 minute on 2018? What a year when you analyze that. So despite the fact that we have a strong economic growth, earnings grow by 20-25% in the US, guess what? Volatility is back on Wall Street. In fact, we have this correction again, 10%. So, according to an analysis made by Deutsche Bank, who have a lot of data back for the last century, to have so many assets, classes or indices in negative return, like whatever is commodity, oil price, whatever you talk about bonds, on corporate bonds, for example, or if you analyze on the equities with a lot of indices down 10, 15, 20%, such a hostile year is something that we have not seen over the last century, as a matter of fact. To make your mind if this correction is a buying opportunity, because we have a long bull market, just like a long bull business cycle. So correction happened many times. In the last 60 years, you have probably seen 55, 60 correction. But is it just a buying opportunity as usual? Or is it maybe on the eve to experiment a bear market, which is minus 20%? That happened only 13 times since the Second War. So you have to make your mind on the business cycle before making your mind on the stock market, because it's very unusual to have a bear market without a recession. So here we are, what is the outlook for 2019? Are we heading to a recession? So if you go with the traditional leading indicator that the Fed watch, the good news is the probability of recession is still very low. It's probably around 25%. So it's higher than it was 3 months ago, because we talk about 15%. But if you go with the ISM leading indicator, or even some coincident indicator like job creation, so the probability of recession is pretty low. Nonetheless, we have some risk out there. So you can notice the first trade risk is the trade war. So for the time being, look like a ceasefire, because they will not increase the tariff to 25%, so they will negotiate the next 3 months. Nonetheless, this is a risk factor, the trade relationship between between US and China. The other risk factor is Brexit. We will see how things going on. And we have as well the fact that a lot of companies in US have huge leverage. So the household in US have deleveraging, but it's the opposite on corporate America. So a lot of companies has benefit of the low interest rate, and they have increased their debt. So their balance sheet has deteriorated. What they have done, they have go with share buyback, increase the dividends, and they have borrowed. But make no mistake, they have to renew their debt. So the refunding is significant, and now we have the premium risk increase. So we will see. So keep the story short. For the time being, the probability of recession is around 25%. It's still an alternative scenario. Nonetheless, no complacency. We have to watch that, because that creates some turbulence on the Wall Street. On interest rate front, we think the Federal Reserve have mentioned loud and clear they continue to normalize interest rate at a gradual pace. The good news is the inflation has not accelerated yet. So I think they will increase in December, and probably they will make a pause and go on the sideline, given what you see on the Wall Street on the credit spread too. So on Bank of Canada, they have changed their tune. Yesterday, for example, they have mentioned that now we have an output gap, and clear in plain English, I do not see any interest rate increase from Bank of Canada before next summer. So what a change compared to 3 months ago. But Bank of Canada has concern about the fact that saving rates has dropped like a rock in Canada. Saving rates in the US is 5-6%. Saving rates in Canada is very low, close to zero. In addition, notice the energy, what's going on in Alberta. So the oil price drops in a significant way. So for all of the reason, Bank of Canada will take that time to normalize interest rate. As a result, the Canadian dollar, we scale down our optimism, because initially we thought the Canadian dollar would probably be closer to 80 cents next spring. Now we think that it's a trading range. It's stuck probably closer in the 75 cents. So what we do with investment strategy with the stock market? So on the stock market, this is the longest now bull market we have seen since the 20s. From the trough, Wall Street has already increased by 315%, so which is a very significant. But notice, earnings are good, but the stock dropped. In fact, the price-earning ratio has a shift from 18 times to 15 times. Such 3 points drop, this is one of the biggest ever seen in 40 years. So know that some people have a concern about the fact that the Federal Reserve pulled the trigger with less liquidity, plus all this uncertainty, whatever is trade war or Brexit, or even real estate in China. So in Canada, the market has dropped as well. It trades around 13 times, which is interesting. So what we recommend? We have scaled down with our optimism on equities. So we now run more neutral on equities. We think for people who have more 2-3 years time horizon is an opportunity because we see no recession next year. But nonetheless, the volatility increase, they have a possibility of earning recession. So that's the reason we recommend more neutral on equities. Having said that, they have some opportunity. Take banks, for example. The dividend yield on the banks are higher than the GIC that you could have at the same banks. So, and they have already dropped in some cases 15-20%. Is good opportunity. We have as well emerging markets who could provide good opportunity for people. So all in all, this is something that you can consult if you go to the website of IA. We will attach as well the document. And what we recommend to you is to sit with your financial advisor and discuss, because depending what is your time horizon, depending your risk tolerance, they will provide you good advice to have a good portfolio. And remember, the best investment is the investment you can sleep with. So if you have difficulty to deal with a 10% correction, probably you have too much equities in your portfolio. So it's important to have this sub-discussion. So in the meantime, I wish you a very good holidays and have a good 2019 year. Thank you.